When many Australians think of bees, they think of the black and yellow striped variety. But there's other tiny little warriors out there, native to Australia, that I'm so passionate about. Now I'm on a mission to educate, inspire, excite, and create awareness to the young and old about the importance and magic of Australian native bees. It's a beautiful day here at Sydney Taronga Zoo, and I'm so excited to get up close and personal with not only the large animals that they have on display, but also the little ones, the native Australian bees. The zoo is one of my favourite places to visit, and I've caught up with my good friend Elio from the Backyard to Bush exhibit.
Great to see you again.
Hi Mel, great to be here.
So when I think of a zoo, I think of the larger animals like your elephants, giraffes and lions. But what people might not know is here at the zoo, you have Australian native bees. Why is that?
Here at Taronga, we believe to be able to provide opportunities for our guests to get up close and personal with some of the other smaller critters. So like our ecosystem is made up of about 80% of these smaller invertebrates, and they play a really important part in our ecosystem, and quite often they're forgotten.
So Backyard to Bush, you look after that section. Mm-hmm. Tell us what that's all about.
So Backyard to Bush, there's lots of opportunities here. We've got it broken up into three different sections. We've got the backyard, we've got the farm and the bush. And it tells a story as you move through those areas. And you can just see kids walking into this area, and quite often their eyes light up when they see
exactly.
Things like sheep and goats. We provide an opportunity here, a safe environment for people to come in and get up close and personal with some of these invertebrates, and bees make a really good ambassador for the invertebrate cousins.
We've got one of the native bee hives from Taronga Zoo, and we're going to open it up and check if it's ready to be split. I've caught up with my entomologist friend James, who's going to give me a hand and tell us more about native bees.
So what is an entomologist? What do you do?
Well, so entomology is the study of insects. So if you kind of snap the word in half, entomon means insect in ancient Greek, and ology is to study. So entomologists study insects. So these little guys have been living in the playground at Backyard to Bush, flying around with
our
ducks and at the playground, and they've been having a lovely time, hopefully making a lot of honey.
These are your pollen sections, and then these is your honey of the native bee. So this is the advancing front, which basically means all these open cells is where the queen bee is going to lay a little egg in there. They're provisioned with food from the worker bees, and then the worker bees come back and cover it all up. The actual life cycle of a bee is 50 days. So it takes 50 days from them to grow from a little egg to when they're actually born. So James, can you tell us a little bit about the difference between a social bee and a solitary bee? Because these ones are social bees.
Most bees are solitary, and,
yeah.
and they're bees that kind of go about their daily lives and have a tendency to either build little burrows or tunnels where they just have their own kind of, it's like having a little studio apartment.
Yes.
Whereas some other ones just land on a branch at the end of each day and take a bit of a nap to start up the next day.
Right, and Australia's pretty unique because we have over 2,000 Australian native bees.
Absolutely. The diversity here in Australia is staggering.
It's amazing. Oh, and they love your eyelashes, don't they?
sweet eye juices, and they love it.
We do. And so, talking about pollination, is pollination just the bees going from one flower to the next, or is there more to it?
I mean, in the loosest sense, it kind of is.
Yeah.
So the plant needs help to reproduce.
Yes.
And as kind of a gift for the animals that help it reproduce, it gives them some food. So bees are amazing because they have all these really fascinating adaptations. They have eyes that can see UV, so they can target specific types of flowers. They have hairy patches on their legs that allow them to collect more pollen and maximize it. So the adaptations that bees have for not just collecting nectar to make honey, but pollen so that they can actually make more flowers. So this kind of symbiotic relationship has allowed not just flowering plants like the pretty ones in your garden, but all
yep.
sorts of fruits and vegetables and grains and grasses and trees and all sorts of life
That's
happens
amazing.
Because of that relationship.
So James, these bees are stingless. Why is that?
It's because they don't need to be. So for whatever ecological reason, they no longer need to protect themselves, whether it's their habitat or the types of predators they have. The reason to kind of lose that stinging ability, which comes is because it comes at a cost.
Yes.
So having a stinger, having venom, these are all energetically costly things to make and produce and to maintain. So if you're a type of bee that doesn't need to sting, it would be beneficial for you to not waste your energy having that ability.
Ah, that's so interesting.
This hive's brood chamber is only tiny. That means that the hive's not ready to be split. Splitting a hive too early can actually kill both hives. So it's really important to ensure that the hive is healthy and that the brood chamber is large enough to be split. Because this one isn't ready, we're actually going to reseal it and put it back in its original position and check on it again in about 12 months' time.
So James, we've learnt a lot about native bees here at the Taronga Zoo today. What can we do at home to encourage more bees into our backyard?
Right, well, there's a lot of things that we can do. Of course, things like planting gardens that have native flowers. A little bit of water out helps not just other wildlife from the bush, but can be helpful for bees.
Yes.
Keeping your gardens pesticide free. I know that a lot of people want to keep their fruits and veggies safe from pests, but if it kills one insect, it may kill another, and we want to keep our bees safe. And it also keeps the Aussie bush safe and happy and healthy.
Get these guys back up on their little post with their duck friends here in Backyard the Bush. And it already looks like there's a lot of the foragers are looking for how to get back into their home.
So I've returned our hive to its natural location, back with all the ducks. All the little foraging bees are coming home. I'd like to say a huge thank you to Taronga Zoo for having me here today. I've had a brilliant time, learned so much information. Thank you to Elio, and big thanks to you, James, our entomologist. Amazing time today.
Well, thank you for coming out and sharing your passion for bees and your expertise in this field. And in general, thank you for being there for the wild.
We'll catch you next time. Thank you.
If you want to learn more about Australian native bees, be sure to subscribe and check out our other episodes.